Driving through the pretty village of Sarratt in Hertfordshire, it's easy to miss Moor Lane, home of the Cressbeds, owned by the Tyler family since 1868. Moor Lane descends some 300 feet down into the valley of the River Chess, where I met Terry and his daughter Sue, who look after the beds. When farms spend a small fortune on chemicals to increase yields, it's refreshing to find one that relies on nothing other than fresh river water. Bending down to cut cress with a sharpened kitchen knife, I asked Terry about the farm and if he'd ever suffered from back pain.
Not yet. My great-grandfather took over in 1886, took over from a man in his 80s. So it's been here quite a long time. Yeah, one year we had a power cut and lost the lot. But we had a stand in Covent Garden Market then, and that kept us afloat, really. And then one of my uncles, who was one of the partners here, I can't remember what year it was, but he won $25,000 on the premium bond, and that kept us afloat. We select certain beds. And we clear them out like this one here and that one, because they didn't do too good last year. And we reseed them. But the others, they just keep coming back. See, we grow by nature. We don't grow with chemicals. We don't use anything at all. I've been eating them for years and they haven't killed me yet. I'd like to clear more beds out, but we can't get the labour. Or we can't afford the labour. We're better off on the dole. That's half the trouble, I think, with this country at the moment. We don't have to work. From Sarratt to Croxley Green and Watford, there was two buses at 8 o'clock and they was full. People standing upstairs, downstairs, everything else. And you might see 50 or 60 people on bikes going to Watford, you know, and there'd be the same going the other way to Hemel, you know, and now it's all in cars and one bloke in it or one woman. You've got your bean sticks, your pea sticks, you know, shovel handles, fork handles, everything out the beach. And Croxley Green, I'm the last one standing, really.